1968. I was 12 years old. A lot happened that year. Denny McLane won 31 games. The Mod Squad hit the air, and I graduated from Hillcrest Elementary and entered junior high school. But we'll get to that. There's no pretty way to put this. I grew up in the suburbs. I guess most people think of the suburbs as a place with all the disadvantages of the city and none of the advantages of the country, and vice versa. But in a way, those really were the wonder years for us there in the suburbs. It was kind of a golden age for kids. There, that's me. Kevin Arnold, 1968. The summer before junior high school.
There we go.
And I don't mind saying I was a pretty fair little athlete.
It was a pretty hard pass.
Well, yeah, I think it had sort of a reverse spin on it.
Come on, Kevin, stop gabbing with your girlfriend.
She's not my girlfriend.
This was true. Winnie Cooper was not my girlfriend. When we were very little, we used to go down to Harper's Woods and catch fireflies, but we really hadn't hung out at all together since we were about nine.
Uh-oh. Think girlfriend's mad at you? Maybe you better go give her a big French kiss.
Shut up, Wayne.
Hey, girls, come on over here. Kevin's gonna show you what a French kiss is.
What face?
What did you say?
Nothing.
This is the way most of my conversations with my brother Wayne ended. Apparently, he just deeply regretted the fact that I had been born. And he wanted me to feel the same way.
Come on, Wayne!
Let him up!
I'm sorry, Paul. This is a family matter.
That was my best friend, Paul Pfeiffer. Paul was allergic to everything. Wayne used to say he was even allergic to his own snot. Wayne was a really funny guy.
Hey, Wayne! Knock it off before I do the same thing to you.
Winnie's brother, Brian Cooper. He was 19, and for us, he defined cool. He had this really great 59 El Camino. Didn't run, of course, but he was always out there working on it. Sweaty, grease all over his hands. What a guy. That June, he got drafted and packed off to Vietnam. But his car was still out front, up on blocks, as kind of a reminder of who really ran things on our street.
Kevin Arnold, you're Wayne's brother, aren't you?
Well, according to my mother, yes, but my own theory is...
You've got a tough row to hoe, young man. A tough row to hoe.
In one of those quirks of scheduling, my first class was gym. This meant that I had to wake up in the morning, shower, get dressed, go to school, get undressed, run around, shower, and get dressed, all in the space of about 45 minutes.
Well, people, a lot of you probably think this is gym class, huh?
I was overwhelmed by a sudden panic. Things hadn't been going that well so far, but if this wasn't gym class, I was in bigger trouble than I thought.
Well, it's not. People, it's physical education class. Through those doors, they educate your minds. In here, I educate your bodies. I'm an educator, okay? A body educator.
Of course, we didn't realize it at the time, but this guy had the biggest inferiority complex since Napoleon.
People, when you leave this class, you're gonna have smart bodies. Smart